INT7213, Emerging Technologies. For this presentation, we're going to do an overview and background of immune engineering. Some of the firms looking to adopt and commercialize immune engineering. Where immune engineering falls on the Gartner hype cycle. Some of the risks and costs associated with immune engineering. Obstacles to full implementation and commercialization. Some of the opportunities and where we're headed with this emerging technology. The human immune system has been called nature's weapon of mass destruction. It has a dozen major cell types, including several kinds of T cells. It defends against viruses it's never seen before, suppresses cancer, though obviously it can't always do that, and for the most part manages to avoid harming the body's own tissue. It even has a memory, which is the basis of all vaccines. Immune engineering involves taking T cells from a person's bloodstream and, using the virus, adds new DNA instructions to aim them at the type of blood cells that are abnormal or contain a virus or disease, such as cancer or HIV. It was developed to kill abnormal cells from within. It will have the biggest impact on blood cancers, such as leukemia. Some of the firms looking to adopt and commercialize immune engineering include Pfizer, the multinational corporation known for their pharmaceuticals and treatments. Selectus, a small research and development company dedicated to T-cell research. Merck, Bristol-Myers Squibb, two multi-billion pharmaceutical and bioscience providers. The National Institute of Health, an agency of the U.S. Department of Health. And Google Life Sciences, among others. Firms that hold the cure to one of the most feared and prevalent diseases known to mankind have a definite advantage. Since cancer is so common and often deadly, and the treatments such as chemo, radiation, bone marrow transplants take such a hard toll on the body, this non-invasive treatment will be a welcome relief to the millions affected. As you can see from the hype cycle, immune engineering falls in the trough of disillusionment. Much of the media fanfare and initial investor hype has died down. As we have learned, the trough of disillusionment is characterized by interest waning as experiments and implementations fail to deliver. Producers of the technology shake out or fail. Investments continue only if the surviving providers approve their products to the satisfaction of early adopters. However, much of the earlier media fanfare, capital infusion, and hype have tapered off, and we are left with firms trying to get a handle on the technology. Many trials are underway by various firms, but common treatment and commercialization are still 2 to 3 years away. There are risks involved. The infused T cells release cytokines, which are chemical messengers that help the T cells carry out their duties. With cytokine release syndrome, there is a rapid and massive release of cytokines into the bloodstream, which can lead to dangerously high fevers and precipitous drops in blood pressure. Some deaths have resulted. The technology is still unproven in treating solid tumors. As with all clinical drugs and therapies, they are risky by nature, and of course the legal risks are high when death is a possibility. The costs of immune engineering are very high for both the patient and firms looking to invest. For patients, personalized treatment can run in the $300,000 to $500,000 and up range. For firms looking to jump into the market, well, as an example, Pfizer paid $40 million to purchase the rights to Selectus' approach to T cell engineering. Juno Therapeutics paid $125 million to acquire AbVitro, a Boston area company that specializes sequencing the DNA inside single T cells. Special laboratories will need to be constructed near treatment facilities, $10 million plus for a specialized lab, and it must be located within a short delivery distance from a hospital or cancer treatment center. There are, however, some obstacles to implementation. This therapy is still in clinical trials, and although it has proven successful in many patients, some have died. Each treatment is personalized, making it very time-consuming, expensive, and not yet universal at this point. It causes side effects that cannot be predicted. We don't know what we don't know yet. The treatment is expensive, and quite frankly, that puts it out of the reach of most of us. Pfizer is in phase 3 clinical trials, but are also having some difficulties keeping the study accurate. There are some opportunities and benefits, however, to immune engineering. If proven in leukemia cancer treatments, it may very well be carried over to HIV treatments. It may open the door to other treatments as well. Diabetes, multiple sclerosis, etc. may all have an immune engineering trial underway. Commercialization can lower the cost as treatments become more common, and universal T cells, the next generation of treatment, is being developed based on this current breakthrough. It will not be patient specific, and specific centers will not need to be utilized in order to treat patients. So, you may be asking yourself, well, where are we headed with this? Many firms are doing clinical trials on mice, mammals, and yes, humans. There are still a lot of unknowns, different types of side effects, how patients react, drug interactions, etc. But it is my belief that this emerging technology will be available in our lifetimes, and when it is, we can all look back and say, I remember when.
Good.